your watch. Down.
No, Sears, this morning.
How could you?
It was just a watch. A special watch, perhaps, but just a watch.
No, William, it was not just a watch. It was so much more than that. The thought of you selling your watch to pay for Mother's vanity drives me to distraction. I won't listen to that, Belle. I won't.
Abby, I didn't sell it for your mother's vanity. I sold it because I wanted to. And you shall listen to the bell. And when you hear it, you won't think of the frailties we possess, but the glories to which we aspire. And that watch is just a small price to pay to know that God's in his head.
I hope I'm not intruding. Abigail, what are you crying for, child?
Mother, I think there's something you should know.
Abby, you tell me why you're crying.
I've been crying, Mother, because the good graces and an act of generosity lift us all closer to heaven. And right now, I feel very close indeed. Merry Christmas, Mother.
Merry Christmas, my precious daughter. Well, how do I look?
Oh, you got a fine figure in that bonnet, Mother Hawkins.
I hope you'll wear it to church this morning.
Oh, indeed I shall. And speaking of generosity, William, I know that with the cost of the veil, and, well, there was really no need to, what I'm trying to say is thank you. I love the bonnet.
You're welcome. And thank you for the handkerchiefs. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to get the money ready for Reverend Fowler. Abby, have you seen an envelope on my desk?
No, I haven't been at your desk all day.
Well, I know it was here.
But perhaps Nora moved it.
No, Nora knows better than to move things from my desk.
Well, surely you don't think someone might have taken it.
Oh, check quickly.
No, no one would have taken it. But...
But who?
But Nick.
Infamy!
No, he couldn't. He wouldn't.
No, of course not. Why would he?
Well, I did offer it to him if he needed it for travel, and...
Oh,